Thanks very much. My name is Thomas Ongolo. I work with the Secretariat of the African Decade for Persons with Disability, based in Pretoria, South Africa. We are a continental technical agency that works towards including people with disability in policy programs in the continent as part of the AU's initiative to raise issues of persons with disability within the decade of 2010-2019. I'm here in Geneva at WIPO, World Intellectual Property Rights Organization, this week as part of the broader blindness movement in the world that are pushing for the treaty for blind persons in the world. And it's quite important that we acknowledge that where we come from, issues of access to material, books, is of concern. We can share documents across borders. And indeed, it's very big concern that this exclusion, the famine that exists for us not to access information, is what brings us up in Geneva this week. So the TBI, the Treaty for Blind in terms of intellectual right, is one thing which we also, as part of the African Decade, see as dear to us, because we'll be adding our voices to the African group to push and endorse this treaty, as opposed to the broader comprehensive agenda which the different African positions are holding towards having on board education and library as a part of a broader comprehensive treaty. And we are seeing that we have come a long way, and the TBI, the Treaty for Blind Persons, it's ready and dusted, and should be put on the table with other comments, and we move on. And that will, at the end of the day, create access to blind people, especially in Africa.
Thomas, if the treaty was going to pass with the provisions that permit the cross-border exchange of accessible works for blind people, and these minimum exceptions that all countries have to follow, how would that change the life of people in Africa who are blind?
The biggest right that the blind people in Africa, which they have claimed, is through the CRPD. And education is a pillar in terms of access, not only to socioeconomic rights, but for inclusion within the society. And we are aware that the cost of production of books within the continent at a country level is high. And this can be drastically reduced by just sharing copyright. And that's what we're talking about, that equal opportunities that we are talking about, blind people breaking barriers, crossing into professions which were previously blocked out because of lack of materials. And we are saying that blind people in Africa are not different from blind people in the north. With access to books and materials, they'd be able to break the ceiling, join other professions, unlike what we have right now, that you find blind people being blocked in terms of professions. You can either be a teacher or a lawyer or one of the few restricted. But with enabling environment, I think education would be totally different.
Well, thank you very much. Is there, before we conclude the interview, is there anything you'd like to add?
I think it's a long journey. it will call for a lot of solidarity, a lot of pressuring and advocacy as a part of a collective effort. And thanks very much for KI for reaching out and giving all the technical support here in Geneva.
That's a very generous comment for you. Thank you very much.
Thanks very much.